Welcome to our YouTube channel and welcome to this awesome video, one of the most important videos you'll be watching on trading. And this has to do with how to choose a good forex broker. And then I'm going to give you my own broker, our own broker here at Differ Trading Hub, as a trading company owned by our C2S Enterprises. And it is going to be a step-by-step guide on how to set up an account with these guys. They are very, very awesome, and that's why we're actually referring them to you guys. So let's get straight to it. But then let's please kindly subscribe to this channel. We drop very cool videos. We drop analysis videos during weekends. We also drop cool videos on all we do, digital marketing, e-commerce, and trading proper. So you don't want to be missing all this content. So kindly subscribe, enable notifications so you get alerted whenever we drop these cool videos. Also share and like the video, so it helps the algorithm so that a lot of people can get recommended to these videos, and then everyone gets better and everyone's happy. So let's get straight at it. Let's first state out the terms of having a good broker. Now, how to choose a good broker. Now, a good broker must be regulated. They must be regulated, yes. People tend to misbehave if they're not regulated. I don't care who or where you want these guys to be regulated, as in they just have to be regulated, because when people are not regulated, they tend to misbehave. That's the more reason why most governments are messing up, because they don't report to anybody. They feel that they're in charge. So you don't want that with your broker's place. So they must be transparent. You don't want brokers that are fishy. Understand, every actions by the brokers must be transparent, and you must understand what they are really doing. Understand, there are a lot of brokers who manipulate spreads, so you don't want to be prey to all this nonsense. So they must have tighter spreads. This is very, very important, because these spreads are what determines that you're really going to buy really low and you're really going to sell high. Understand, which is our goal in forex trading. So your broker must have tighter spreads. I understand that this spread is where brokers make their money from, but you understand, you don't want them to be abusing that privilege. So please ensure the spreads. And then they must have reliable customer support, or even a private account manager if possible. Now, I know brokers, they might have their head office in whatever country, but you want brokers that have good customer support, one. And then a private account manager. Even before we get to this, your broker should be able to have an office in your country. If they have their head office, or they have their head operations in another country, they should be able to have a branch in your country. Understand? And then on that, they should be able to, good brokers these days, they give you a private account manager. Now, this account manager, whoever he or she is, if it's a he or she, for me is your best friend in terms of trading with that account, because this guy or this girl is who is actually going to ensure that whenever you have problems, they are being sorted faster. Understand? Because if you go through the broker, some little time will be wasted along the line. But this person ensures that, look, everything is going cool with you in your account, because that's actually his or her job. So please ensure that your broker is giving you this. But if they're not giving you this, then they should have good customer support either ways. So they must have swift deposits and withdrawal process. For me, this is the most important aspect. I know most brokers, they have swift deposit process, but the worst of them have both bad deposit process and bad withdrawal process. I can't even imagine how those guys are still in business. But that's being said, I understand that the energy people give you while taking your money, which is deposit, is very, very different and while taking your money and while withdrawing your money, which is withdrawal. I understand that's a normal human factor. Understand, but you don't want, I think for me, 24 hours for my withdrawal, 2 days, a day or two is okay. Anything more than that is not okay. Understand? So just make sure your broker has swift withdrawal and deposit process. You know, now if you can actually go about this, but just make sure, for me, these are the five most important things. Your broker must check all these boxes. It's a must. If you don't want to have a bad broker, understand? Having a good broker is actually what's going to ensure that is part of the reasons that are going to ensure that you're going to be successful in trading. That's just the truth. So ensure that they tick all these boxes. And now we have chosen a good broker, which is our own broker. This broker is very, very nice, very, very awesome. Nice is just an understatement. So they tick all these boxes, and they also have cool features as in within them, which you are going to see in this video. Why we really chose these guys. Understand? They are very, very awesome. Understand? So I give it out to them. So let's go straight at it. Remember, subscribe, enable notification, and then like and share this video to your friends. Thank you. Let's get over to what the main thing we have today. Forex time. Now I'm going to give a link to the FXTM. Our brokers are FXTM. I'm going to give a link to register on the FXTM platform. Now you sign up with this link, they're going to give you, I've forgotten what they do give, but they give us some decent sign up bonuses. So endeavor to use this link, because if you use a normal link, you're not going to get it. So I'm going to drop this link in the description box. Endeavor to use this link, or unless you're not interested in whatever they have to, but what is a bonus for you. So I don't see why you shouldn't use the link. So that's just it. So you open an account, go to open an account, going ahead, let's put the mobile number. So you fill in your email. I'm gonna use my second email. And you're gonna set a password, and they are gonna ask you to confirm your PIN, your phone number, by sending you a PIN. So let's check for the PIN. Still expecting it. So I'm gonna put the PIN. So you agree to terms, and then you register now. That's it, guys. You have created an account with them. So let's go over to setting things up a bit. As you can see, there are a lot of things you can do here. So I'm going to take you through as in all of them. So let's go ahead. First we create a demo account for these training. Create a demo account. Can create a demo account. Can you fill these forms? So now we can create a live trade, but I don't want to create a live trading account. Like I told you guys, this is my, I just opened this for the sake of this train. So I'm just account type. Now here's where things again, there are many kinds of accounts you can open here. So we'll go through them. We have the for FSTM stocks on MT5. We have CFD, FST stocks CFD on MT4. We have standard MT4, standard MT5. But the ones I want you to interest yourself with here is mainly, I think there's a place they give a rundown of what these accounts look like, the properties of each account. Okay, yeah. Learn more about our accounts. Let's learn more about the accounts so that I don't want it to come directly from my mom. I just want you to see everything here. So now, okay, yes, this is what I'm looking for. Now have the standard and the ECN accounts. Now go over the benefits of all this. Now we have the trading platforms, accounts, leverage, margin. This for a standard account. We have the standard. On the standard accounts, we have standard cents and we have stock CFZs. Yes, ECN, the cents and stocks, ECN accounts, ECN, blah 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 that. These stocks, they contain a lot of useful information that you have access to. Just go through this. I can't start going through them one by one. It's going to take a lot of time. But just know that ECN accounts, they require, they have tighter spreads. This is the main difference. They have tighter spreads than the standard accounts. But here is the thing. ECN, the minimum deposits for ECN accounts are far bigger than the standard account. On the standard account, you can see a typical standard account, you can open with $100, you can see here, and this is the cent account. The cent account is $10 or euros or whatever, $100. But in the ECN account, can see ECN $500. Understand? Why I like this broker is because there is something for everybody here. I love this broker a lot, especially for those of you starting out, because I've had a lot of students in the past and they want to start with $100, but you know, $100 is a typical, as it's very, very small. So, but now you can use, they have a cent account. See, a cent account. Now, with the cent accounts, the minimum deposit is $10. But here's the thing. This cent account, your $10 on this cent account is equivalent to $1 is 100 cents. Understand? So, $10 is equal to 1,000 cents. So in your account, you'll be seeing 1,000, the value of 1,000. What this means is that you can use lot sizes, you can use this thing, you can enter positions as if you had $1,000 in your account. That's the good thing here, guys. But when you earn or when you lose, as in your profit and losses are going to be in cents, so that when you convert it, you see it's back to dollar. But at least it's good. And trading and seeing that value and trading like you have a big account is enough confidence already, if you know what you're doing. So I suggest if you're a beginner, you have a small account, this is nice. This is actually another reason I'm referring these guys to you guys. Very, very nice. So let's go over to what we're doing before. Now, we can open, I don't want to open a live account like I said before. I just want to open a demo here. So I'm going to go to open a new account. So since you are using, for most of us starting, most of you starting as beginners, I suggest you use the standard account, ECN are for professionals like us or thereabout. So just start up with, it doesn't matter, you can have a standard account, you can have a cent account, you can have stock, you can have all these accounts under this, all these trading, these are trading accounts by the way, you can have all of them under this account. So opening a standard account doesn't mean that you open an ECN account in the future. Understand? So just start cut your quota according to your size at this early stage. So we are going for demo trading. This is what we're going for the sake of this tutorial. So I'm gonna select demo, open a demo account. Let's just say I want a standard MT4 USD leverage. Now leverage is very, very important. Don't over leverage. Understand? Somewhere around 1 to 500 or 1 to 1,000 is okay. We recommend 1 to 100, but it won't be bad too if you go for 1 to 500, 1 to 1,000. Understand? But don't go anything above 1,000. Don't try that. On a normal basis, you shouldn't be going for this. You shouldn't be going for 100. You should be somewhere here. Want to remember, don't over leverage. But like I said, in Forex, most things have been made easy. All these things, they have been made easy in such a way that you don't need to stress yourself for this. If you have a good broker, it handles all this. So let's just say I'm going to for 1 to 500. So I'm going to set a password here. Okay. Confirm is this. So I'm doing this so that you, this is just the same steps with opening a live account, just that this demo, you can see when it in the previous slide, you can see you saw that it was an open live trading account. Now it's open demo, so it's just the same thing. So initial balance, let's just say 1,000 for the sake of tutorials, then open account. So that's it. So that's it. You can see it. This is just what it looks like if we're using a live account. So let's go over to the next stuff. Let's look at our documents, because this is the next thing. You really need this. You need to verify your profile. Very, very important. So here you upload your identity documents, you upload your proof of residence. These are the two things you upload. You just press here, you can see, when you press upload for identity document ID, it will ask you to upload the front side, the front of your ID, and then the back. click browse, it will take you to your system. You select where it is on your system. You can see, you can select where it is on your system. So same with back. So when you are done with that, when you're done with that, you press upload, and that's it. You wait for them to give you a reply. So there's same thing for this other guy. Let's go back to same thing for the proof of residence. You click upload, you go there, you select the the file where it is on your system, and then you go for it, you press upload, and that's it. So you wait for them. But if you want to speed up process now, because at this point they are going to give you an account manager for sure, but at this point you might not have an account manager yet. So to speed things up, you can live chat. That's what I can remember setting this in the reasons and in the criteria for having a group broker. You can see they have a live chat, they have WhatsApp, they have Viber, you have Telegram, you have Facebook chat, that's Facebook Messenger, you have callback. Look, these guys, they're everywhere. Understand, there's no way you're not going to reach them. This aside the fact that they also give you a private account manager. So these guys are so good for me. So let's just say I want to live chat. Live chat, you can see you. Can see your name. Can see your name. Say Mamba Steven. Mamba Steven. And then your email. You can put the email of this account. And put the email of this account. So you put the email of this account, and then you click send. You click send. When you click send, okay, I don't know if I should be doing all this. Let me just be doing them though. But these things are pretty simple steps. Don't want to. So here you can see, you're already with a bot, but they're going to reply. The main customers and service agent will reply to. So you can say this after you have uploaded this, and you want to speed up the process. You can say hi. Can say hi Florence, can you help me verify the documents I just uploaded? So that's it. When you send it, when you type this, you send it to them. So I didn't upload any documents, so obviously I'm not going to send. But I'm just giving you a hint. When you send this, they're going to give you a reply, and then this can speed up the whole process. You understand? So that's it, guys. And use these tools. They are there for you. Don't be afraid to use any of them. So after verifying your profile, verify payment. Is that even a thing I should be telling you about? It's not. Method. So let's go over the deposits and the deposit methods. My money, go to my money. You can see deposit funds. This is another great thing about this. I told you these guys are everywhere. Look, they have credit card deposit and credit debit card as a deposit method. All these deposit methods, you can deposit and withdraw through via this. We're going to go over the withdrawal, by the way. They have bank transfers. You can see bank transfers, different banks. They have e-wallets, Creo, these guys, and web money, perfect money, even Bitcoin. So you can see these guys are everywhere. So I usually, now this is the thing. For people in countries like Africa, or I don't know, as in if you live in places where this Visa and MasterCard take a lot of time, because I'm speaking, it might not take time for deposit. Like I told you, the same the energy people use for collecting your money is not the energy they give you when you're taking it back. So if you're living in those countries, I think you should be going for bank transfers. Don't go for this, because by the way, remember that the method you use for deposit, that's the method you use for withdrawal. Go for bank transfers, the wire transfer, or anyone you want to call it. It's faster, you understand? But here, the payment has to go through Visa, InterSwitch, before going to the broker. Then the broker will give you a feedback and all that. But for bank transfers, you just send the money straight up into your account, and the same for deposits, you send the money to the account, and that's it, they credit you. So and you can see, let's go to withdraw funds. You can see the same methods. We have local payment methods for Africa, for a country, I mean Nigeria, so that's why it is showing this way. We have debit cards, we have bank transfers, we have e-wallets. These guys, they have, they will give you value in every possible way. Understand? So that's just that. Now when you fund, when you deposit, this is how, this is the next thing you do. You can choose to deposit. Let me go through the deposit. You can choose to deposit. Let's say you're depositing through bank transfers in a bank. So you can choose to deposit, say an account. You have an option to choose your local currency account, Nigerian Naira in this case. You have GBP, you have USD, you have Euro. So whatever account you have, you choose it. So I think my wallet is, this wallet should be in USD. So you can make, you make a, you enter this code in your bank transfer payment description. In your payment description, in your pay, in your deposit, you put this. So you can copy the code. Then you choose the currency your bank account is, the currency you're paying in. This doesn't look, you can have USD here. This is your wallet and denomination. That's your wallet currency. But this currency is the currency you're paying in. So why they're doing this, so that if you have a Naira account, it's not going to be a difficulty if you have, if you want to transfer from this Naira account to this USD account. You understand? So they are going to automatically convert everything for you. They just make things easy for you guys. So that's it. You can see the account you're going to pay in. You pay into this account and you add that code in your description details. Transfer description. You just add these things on your transaction description details. This account number and then this unique code. The unique code, this code here. This code here. So that's it. You print, but you can print it. Then if you make a transfer and put this, if it's on a working day, is going to your deposit is going to reflect almost instantaneously. Understand? But if it's on a weekend, it might take till the next working day. You can see 1 to 3 business points, 1 to 3 business days. Understand? So that's it, guys. So let's go over to the next this thing. When you do this, you should be ready to trade. That's it. So remember, let's go through the steps again. You sign up, which we did. We complete your profile. You put your date of birth and all those stuff we added there. You open a trading, and now I want you guys to do something. Open a trade, a live trading account, and open a demo account. Now the live trading account is what you're going to use for trading when you're ready to trade live, guys. Now the demo account is what we'll be using for this training. Now you must do this. Do this now. After is an exercise after this video. Open 2 accounts, open a real account and a demo account, and then the demo account is what we're going to be using for practice. You don't want to be practicing with a real account. You only trade live when you're ready. So you make a deposit, as and when you're ready to start and trading live. This is not for now, so start trading. Then you complete, like I said before, sign up, complete profile, open these 2 accounts. You verify your documents. That's four. I told you, sign up 1. This one is 2. Complete profile. This one is 3. Open the 3 accounts. Documents is 4. So these 4 things are primary. Then the deposit and withdrawal will come later when you're ready to start trading live. So let's go over to MT4. Now you can see, you can download the platform. Okay, you use their web trader. The web trader is this, the MT4 on the site. The site MT4. So, site MT4. Then you can also download the platforms. Look at the platforms and look at it. And we have FXTM Trader Mobile for iPhone. We have for Android. We have FXTM Web Trader, which we already here already. This is, you can see the web trader. You log into the web trader and then it takes you there. FXTM Trading Terminal for PC. FSTM for, so I think you download this, or for those of you using any mobile phones, you can download Android or iPhone, you can download it on your phone. If you're doing this, if you download it, if you click this, it'll take you to Play Store. So for PC, you can download, you can see, you can download. So guys, that's it. That's it. Now you know how to open an account with FXTM broker. This one of the best complete guides you can ever get in opening an account with a good broker, and how to choose a good broker, and how to open an account with one. So kindly use the link, like I said, use the link in the description below so that you receive some benefits. Sign up with that link, because if you use a normal link, I don't think you get anything. So just try and do that. Now if you have any questions on any of the steps just as in this video, just kindly leave the question in the comment section. We are surely going to attend to all those questions. Please, if you also have any ideas, any other videos you want us to make, just let us know. Be free, you understand, you don't pay for this. This is YouTube. Also subscribe, enable notification, and please like and share this video. We actually started doing this for a reason. We want people to get value, understand, in trading. It's in everyone's interest for you to spread the word. Please share the love, please, either by sharing this video and also by liking, because these things they help the algorithm, and YouTube tends to recommend these videos to more people if these things are happening in a video. So please kindly look forward to more of these videos, and let's see in the next video, please. Thanks, guys.